and all that.
We present Jimmy Clitheroe as the Clitheroe Kid with Peter Sinclair, Patricia Burke, Danny Ross and Diana Day in...
The Kid Makes History!
Breakfast won't be long now, Susan. Will you go and set the table?
Right, Mother. Oh, before I forget, I will be going with you and Grandad to the town hall tonight.
Oh, good. You'll enjoy that home cooking exhibition. Is Alfie coming with us?
No, he's got a snooker match on, and they're playing away. I suppose our Jimmy will be going.
Oh, yes. He's heard all about the free samples.
You mean all that food they give away?
Yes. He says he's thinking of taking a suitcase with him.
He would think of that. Would you open the door, Mother? This tray's a bit heavy.
Yeah, right you are, love.
Oh, flipping egg. I'll never find the daft answer to the rotten question.
Jimmy, what are all these books doing on the table?
I'm doing me homework for Choo-Chin Charlie.
Who?
Mr. Fosdyke, our history master. He has a big chin and he chews gum.
But you can't do your homework at the breakfast table. Why didn't you do it last night?
I did. I was doing me sums for TikTok Tilly.
Who's she?
Our maths teacher, Miss Potter. When she talks, her teeth click.
Look, you'll have to put those books away. I want to set the table.
I won't be a minute. I just want to find an answer to a question.
You mean you're looking for your answers in the encyclopedia? You little cheat.
Well, I'm not cheating. I know the answer. I just want to check it.
What's the question?
What happened in the year 1066?
Well, any fool can tell you that.
Well, you're a fool, you tell me.
Don't be cheeky, I'm not telling you.
All right, skinny ribs. I'll get me mum to tell me.
She won't help you. Anyway, you say you know the answer.
Well, I do. I just want to check the encyclopedia in case they've got it wrong.
Go on, then. What did happen in 1066?
Don't you remember? You were there at the time.
Just tell me your answer.
Well, Captain Cook discovered Australia.
What? Of all the silly answers. In the year 1066, Captain Cook discovered Australia. Oh, very funny.
Here's your breakfast, Jimmy.
Thanks, Mum. Hey, do you know what our Susan just said? In the year 1066, Captain Cook discovered Australia.
What? Oh, Susan, even I know that. 1066 was the Battle of Hastings.
Thanks, Mum. Who said she wouldn't help me, Scraggy Neck?
Mother, you've just given him the answer to one of his homework questions.
Oh, get back in your nest, stool pigeon.
That'll do. Are you still doing that homework?
Well, I've got to get it right. I've got to see my form master today about it.
Who, Mr. Finnegan?
Yeah, Sammy the Snitch.
I've told you before about using that name.
Well, he's got a big nose. Oh, but you needn't worry, Mum. I don't call him Sammy the Snitch anymore.
Well, thank goodness for that.
No, I've got a new name. Percy the Human Pelican.
Now then, Clitheroe, I've kept you in after school because I want to put one or two questions to you.
Well, fire away, sir. If you never ask, you never learn.
Do you want me to give you the cane?
That's an easy question. The answer's no.
Then behave yourself.
Sorry, Mr. Pelican, Finnegan. What did you want to ask me?
It's about your homework for Miss Potter and Mr. Fosdyke.
What about it? Ain't it all right?
No, it is not. It is obvious from your answers that you've been copying off the wrong people.
Oh, very comical, sir. I like that. Very amusing.
It isn't funny.
Oh, I don't know. I've heard worse. No.
Now, that will do. Listen to this. Question. A bath with a capacity of 12 gallons is filled by the tap at the rate of 1 gallon per minute. It empties at the rate of 2 pints every 20 seconds. To fill the bath to the brim, what would you do? Do you recall your answer, Clitheroe?
No, go on, sir. Surprise me.
I'll read it. I would put the plug in the hole.
Well, you must admit it makes sense.
You would leave the tap running for 48 minutes. That's how you would get the bath full.
Yes, and that's how I'd get a spanking.
A spanking?
Yeah, off me grandad for wasting all that hot water.
Don't be funny. We turn now to a question on English history set by Mr. Fosdyke. Why was the famous old Roman road named Watling Street? Answer. So the postman would know where to deliver the letter.
Well, if they didn't give the street a name, he wouldn't be able to find it.
Clitheroe, be quiet and listen to me. Starting tomorrow morning, you will bring your homework to me. And if it doesn't improve, you will report here every Saturday morning for a month for detention class.
What? But I go to the pictures Saturday mornings with my pal Ozzy.
You'll be spending your Saturday mornings with me.
All right, but you'll have to buy your own peanuts.
Look, what is your homework for tonight?
I don't know. I wasn't in class when they gave it out.
Oh, where were you?
I asked to leave the room, and while I was in there, somebody locked the door and I couldn't get out.
You mean you were locked... You were locked in the,
Yeah, and it's not much fun spending half an hour locked in the,
Well, get the questions from Oswald Higginbottom and see that you work harder than... Your efforts recently have been quite atrocious.
Well, I'm sorry, but it's the best me grandad can do. I can do.
Tomorrow morning I shall be waiting for you, 9 o'clock sharp, in my study. Now off you go, Clitheroe.
Yes, Mr. Pelican, Finnegan. He'll be waiting for me, 9 o'clock sharp. In his birdcage.
What a performance. I thought I'd never get home. Where is it and who cooped it?
Don't be funny. Why are you late?
I was held up in school. Now just shove me tea in front of me, I'll do the rest.
In a minute. What were you kept in school for?
Mr. Finnegan asked me to stay behind.
What for?
For half an hour. To help him to find out which naughty lad locked me in the boys.
The boys?
Yes, you know, Susan, the boys.
Yeah, that's right, Susan. At the school you went to, they call it the girls.
Now, listen, is that the only reason you were kept in, Jimmy?
Yes, can I have me tea? We'll have to hurry if we're going to the town hall.
Oh, there you are, Jimmy. Now, what were you?
All right, I'll talk to you on the way to the town hall.
You're not going to the town hall.
Why not?
I've just been talking to Mr. Finnegan.
Oh, heck, bang goes me free sausage rolls.
What's the matter, Father?
It's that wee scamp. Did you know Finnegan kept him in after the school today?
Yes, he told us. It was to do with him being locked in the...
He was kept in because of his homework. All his answers are wrong, and I've been helping him.
Oh, well, that explains it.
Shut up. What did Mr. Finnegan say, Father?
Well, apart from saying I've been helping him, he said, oh, Jimmy's going to be bottom of the class the way he's going. Mr. Finnegan said we're to see that Jimmy gets the homework questions from Ossie and spends the evening working on them.
Don't worry, he will. You're right, Father. He's not going to the town hall.
Oh, it's not fair. You said I could go.
You're staying in to do your homework. And if it isn't finished properly by the time I get back, I'll get my slipper to you. Now, do you understand?
All right, but this is Daft Finnegan's fault. I hope that old pelican gets foul pest. Hello! Hello! Oh, heck, why don't they answer? I'm never going to get the rotten questions at this rate. Hello! Come on, Ozzy. What's that funny buzzing noise? Perhaps he swallowed a bee. Oh, heck, what's the use? I'm coming!
Hello, Jimmy, it's me.
Alfie, what are you doing here?
I've got to take Susan to the pictures.
Yeah, daft thing, she's gone out.
That's all right. We don't have to be there till 7:15, so I'll wait.
For about 25 hours?
Yeah, you are.
You're taking her out tomorrow night, not tonight.
Give over. We arranged it all. I was playing snooker tonight, but they altered the day because it's an away match and some of them can only get off early on early closing night, so now I'm meeting the team on the coach at 6 o'clock on Thursday.
And it's now 6:30 on Thursday.
Yes, so there you... Is it?
Yeah, today's Thursday, you dope.
Oh, I can miss the bus.
Oh, you missed it years ago. Your head's like Ozzy's phone.
You what?
That's out of order as well.
Look, before I thump you, tell me what you're going on about.
I want to ring Ozzy for me homework questions, but every time I dial the number, I get a funny noise.
Oh, well, I'll tell you what you want to do. Ring the post office and ask them to test it.
Your head?
Yeah. No. Ozzy's phone. Well, what's the number?
Central 5753.
Right, I'll show you what to do. Yeah, all you do is dial O.
Oh.
That's right, O.
Number, please.
Hello.
Number, please.
I want to report a fault.
I see. What is your number?
Central 2457, but that's no use because it's mine.
Pardon?
But that's it when I'm at home, but I'm not home at Jimmy's.
Give it to me. Look, do you know if Central 5753 is out of order?
Hang on. Yes. I've got a note of it. It won't be put right till tomorrow morning.
But I want to ring them now. It'll be too late tomorrow. Can't you send a man round to...
No, I can't! Now, please get off the line.
Oh, pull your plug out. There's nothing else for it. Come on, Alfie, we're going for a ride on your motorbike.
Where to?
To Ozzy's to get me homework questions.
Oh, but Jimmy, what about Susan?
You'll see her when she gets back. Just help me with me homework, and when Scragonette comes home, you can start on your homework.
It's no use going on knocking, there's nobody in.
Oh, heck. I've got to get them homework questions from Ozzy somehow.
You can't if he's not there.
No, but I bet his boots are. Let's go round the back and see if there's a window open.
Yeah, not likely. You're not breaking in the house, Mr. Higginbottom had murdered you.
All right, I'll stay here. You go round the back and get in.
That's better. I'll go... Oh, no. No. I'm not getting into bother with Higginbottom. I'd sooner tackle a wild bull.
He just shouts a lot. He's got a big mouth.
Ah, well, I'm not putting my head in it.
Putting your head in where, lad?
In your mouth. Hello, Mr. Bull. Higginbottom.
You what?
The letterbox, he was looking through it.
Yeah, I couldn't get my head in. But see it. Go through it.
Don't bother. What are you doing here, Clitheroe?
I came to see Ozzy.
Well, he's out with his mother. Clear off, I've got work to do.
But I've got to get the homework off Ozzy.
You will not. I told Ozzy not to let you copy off him anymore. He's been a fool too long.
Well, he might grow out of it.
What?
he meant he's grown. You're up. Jimmy doesn't want the answers to the questions. He wants the questions to the answers. what it is. The homework. The questions.
Alfie. Try talking through your nose and give your mouth a rest.
Look, Mr. Higginbottom, all I want is to find out what homework we've got to do tonight. Can I come in and look at Ozzy's notes?
Oh, all right. I'd forgotten. You can't copy Ozzy's answers. He's not doing it till he gets back.
Thanks, Mr. Higginbottom.
Come in, then. And you, Alfie.
All right, yeah.
His books are in the living room there.
Right, Mr. Higginbottom. Come on, Alfie.
And don't make a mess.
Don't make a mess, he says. Ooh, look at this room, Alfie.
I wouldn't call it a living room.
Oh, it'd be all right to live in if your name was Porky. They don't eat here anyway.
Well, how do you know?
There's no trough.
Hey, shut up, he might be here. Get love for Ozzy's boots.
Hey, Alfie, look at this picture.
What is it?
I think it's a photo of Mr. and Mrs. Higginbottom's wedding. She doesn't half look little and fat next to him. She looks like a bell tent next to a telegraph pole.
Hey, stop it. You're supposed to be finding Ozzy's... Oh, here they are.
Oh, Alfie, look at the hat on this woman next to Mr. Higginbottom. It looks like a fruit salad on a stick.
Yeah, I've got the homework book. Let me see here. Oh, it's a story after that. Imagine you were with Hannibal when he crossed the Alps and wrote the story in the form of a diary. Hey, Jimmy, that's not easy, is it?
Oh, never mind that for a minute. Look at all these photos. Look, Mr. Higginbottom and some women on the sands with donkeys, eh? And don't ask me which are the donkeys.
Yeah, it's not all that easy to tell. Hey, look at that funny-looking woman there.
That funny-looking woman is my sister.
Maybe it's Mr. Higginbottom. I didn't mean to say...
Which is your sister, Mr. Higginbottom?
There, on the right.
Oh, Alfie didn't mean her, did he, Alfie?
Eh? No, oh, no, no.
He meant the one on the left.
Yes, that's a funny-looking one.
That's my mother. Oh, hey. Look, get out. Come on, both of you, clear off. Prying into people's things.
But I haven't finished copying the homework down.
That's too bad. With a bit of luck, you'll get the cane. Now get out.
But, Mr...
Out, I said.
Oh, come on, Jimmy, let's go quick. I saw the questions for your homework.
Oh, all right, I'm coming.
I'm sorry, Mr. Higginbottom, for looking at your funny family. But saying it.
I know who's to blame, Alfie. Clitheroe there.
What? Don't blame me, because you've got a funny family. Blame your grandfather.
Look, you're going to write the story yourself. I've looked it up for you in the history book. I'm doing no more. Hannibal crossed the Alps with his elephants in 218 BC.
I knew that. We did it last week. But that's all I remember.
Nobody knows what happened every day. You just have to make it up. You know, like a diary.
Hey, I wonder where he got his elephants from.
He bought them, I suppose.
Don't be daft. You can't walk into a shop and say, 3 dozen elephants, please. Don't wrap them up, I'll take them with me.
Well, he didn't grow them, did he?
I bet he bought them off a circus.
A circus?
Yeah. No, he'd attack the circus and pinch them with the trainers. Hey, how about that?
What?
I'll make up a story where I was the elephant boy in a circus. Sabu Jim. All of us could be in it. Grandad the ringmaster, Mam the gypsy, you be the clown, that's obvious. And Susan, what could Scraggy do?
Yeah, watch it.
She could cook for the elephants. They must have strong stomachs. That's it.
Yeah, it is stupid.
Oh, yeah, listen to this. It was Thursday the 12th of whatnot. And the circus boy and the clown were shivering in their tent on top of the Alps near the elephant garage.
The elephant garage?
Yeah, where you park elephants. They were waiting for Hannibal the Horrible, known as the Wild Bull of the Mountains. Alfie, open the tent flap.
Yeah, what for?
I think our Susan wants to come in.
Now, don't be funny. That's one of your elephants, Sabu.
Let's see. Which one is it? Oh, it's you, Nelly.
You don't look after the elephants as you should. I'm the clown, but I had to bring them all the way up the freezing Alps. You mean, it was no joke. Perched upon an elephant with the snow swirling round me out there.
All right, I asked you to bring them up, but you didn't have to teach them daft tricks, teaching them how to waltz.
What's wrong with that?
Who wants to dance with an elephant?
You're on again, are you, Sabu? Just because Alfie teaches them tricks better than you.
Who asked you, Scraggy? Get cooking some of your elephant swill. Anyway, Alfie's got flat feet. That's how daft he is.
How does that make him daft?
You didn't see how he got his flat feet. I ask you, telling an elephant to sit while he was standing underneath it.
Jim, that's a ringmaster, your granddad.
Sounds like elephants to me.
I mean, he's bringing them up for Hannibal's inspection.
Yes, that's your job, not granddad's.
He rounds them up quicker. One toot on his bagpipes and they run for their lives.
Elephant! Elephant! Halt! 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 Whoa! 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 Whoa!
The daft old grandad. He's not the cook house down again.
Oh, very
I'm sorry about the cookhouse, son. The elephants didn't hear me. I think the wind's in the wrong direction.
It must be. If they'd smelled our Susan's cooking, they'd have run the other way.
Oh, the crystal ball tells me trouble is on the way. Great trouble is approaching.
Oh, it's Gypsy Rose Mum. What sort of trouble?
Hannibal the Horrible is coming over for the inspection.
Alfie, quick, hide the elephant.
Too late. Hannibal comes now.
Greetings, mighty Hannibal, general of our victorious army, conqueror of the world, the mighty soldier of...
Never mind the guff. What have you done to my cookhouse?
Oh, you noticed it then?
Noticed it? How are in it? I was just getting stuck into a plate of sausages when the roof fell in. And when I came round, one of your thieving elephants had eaten all me bangers.
That'd be Nelly. She likes a good banger, does Nelly?
All right, Sabu Jim. Tomorrow morning, you better make sure them elephants do as good a job on the gates of Rome as they did on my cookhouse.
Don't worry, Horrible, Hannibal. They'll get through even if Alfie dies in the attempt. Now, Alfie, this is what you have to do. Friday the 13th. Unlucky for some.
For you, Sabu. Here we are at the gates of Rome. And you've lost your perishing elephants.
I'm sorry, Mr. Hannibal, but I told Alfie to sleep with the elephants all night.
Well, why are they missing?
Well, he snores a lot.
So shut up. Look, we've got to get into Rome. So since you've lost the elephants, go down there and get them gates open yourself.
But I might be killed.
That's right. Get out. Go on.
Yes, sir. There's nobody in.
Don't be daft.
Coliseum. There's a notice pinned on the gates.
What does it say?
Coliseum, for one day only, the sensation of the age, Alfie and his waltzing elephants.
Wait till I get my hands on him. He'll dance on the end of a rope.
And so they went back to the circus, the family carrying the bags and the elephants carrying their trunks. The end. How does that sound, Alfie?
You're right, load of drivel. Your history master will murder you.
Why?
It's all so daft.
Yeah, I should have kept you out of it. Still, it's too late to alter it now. It's nearly 9:15.
Wait, is that your bedtime tonight?
It's television time. Boxing.
It started. Oh, no, it's a phone.
Will you answer it, Alfie, please? I'll turn the telly on and warm it up.
Yeah, all right. It might be Susan anyway, so I'll give her a surprise.
More like a shock. Should be some good fights on tonight. Hope Ozzy's not watching in case I see any new punches. Then I can show him them tomorrow.
We take you over now to Birmingham for amateur boxing.
Jimmy, that was Ozzy on the phone.
Quiet, Alfie, it's on.
We'll have it off.
What are you doing?
Well, that was Ozzy phoning about your homework.
Oh, yeah? Well, he's not copying my story.
No, he doesn't want to. That story's got to be written over the weekend. It's for Monday.
Huh? Oh, well, that's all right. Wait a minute, though.
Yes. Tonight's homework is the first 10 sums on page 25 of your arithmetic book.
Oh, no. You mean you've messed it up?
I did.
I'm glad you own up. Well, get the rotten boot and take your shoes and socks off.
Shoes and socks off? What for?
We're doing hard sums now. You might have to count up to 20.
Those involved with the Clitheroe Kid this week were Peter Sinclair as grandfather, Patricia Burke as mother, Danny Ross as Alfie Hall, Diana Day as Susan, Tony Menaday as Mr. Higginbottom, and David Case as the teacher. The recorded program was written by James Casey and Frank Roscoe, produced by James Casey, and starred Jimmy Clitheroe as the kid himself.